Mainz at 15.0, which is plus 1,400. A draw at 7.6, which is plus 760. And Bayern Munich at 1.21, minus 467. How have you got the value on Munich?
Yeah, value on Munich, of course, not on the money line market or on the winners market, how we say in Europe, but we will combine that with the goals market. So we're going Bayern Munich and over 3.5 goals in the match at 1.91, minus 110 in US odds. I think that Bayern are scoring goals for fun right now. They kicked off the second half to their season in style, and they are trailing by just 1 point RB Leipzig. They scored 9 goals in their 2 matches. They covered the over 3.5 goals on their own in the last 2 matches, as we predicted. And Mainz, I think that they might help us even better. I think that Mainz might help us to win this bet, because I think that Mainz have the weapons to find the back of the net at home against the Bayern Munich. But I can see Bayern Munich easily winning this match and putting some pressure on RB Leipzig, who failed to win last week against Eintracht Frankfurt.
Okay, Radek, we're going to come to you. Hoffenheim at 3.24, plus 224. The draw at 3.82, which is plus 282. And Leverkusen, 2.2 at plus 120. Where's the Radek money going?
Onto goals here. I don't see a winner. Leverkusen had 2 strong games, especially the last one was very good of them. And I think they are climbing and climbing, and now they're 5th in the standings. And I think they can move on if they, yeah, can beat Hoffenheim. I think they're better, but in one case, I see goals here, and if I bet on over 3 goals, I get back the money. If there are 3 goals and I win the bet, if there are more than 3 goals and the odds are around 2, I think 1.95 in a game between a scoring team like Hoffenheim and, on the other hand, maybe one of the best scoring teams with Leverkusen. So I like this.
Okay, so Radek's going for over 3 goals on the Asian handicap at 1.95, which is minus 105. Alex, where are you going?
This is my banker of the week. I took it from Monday. I already posted on Twitter. I'm going exactly the same way, over 3 goals on the Asian handicap at 1.95, minus 105 in US odds. Leverkusen in great shape. Yes, you will tell me that they played against 2 relegation sides, Paderborn and Düsseldorf. But I think that this is the best thing that it could happen to them in the start of the second half of their season. Right now, they are prepared to face the best sides. Hoffenheim are one of them. Of course, they are not one of the best sides, but they're a decent side. I didn't expect Hoffenheim to beat Werder Bremen 3-0. I expected a high-scoring affair, but I thought that Werder will contribute on the scoreboard, and don't give me that look, please. So, Leverkusen, great wings with Bellarabi and Diaby, offering some amazing assists for Volland and Kai Havertz, one of my favorite players in Bundesliga. Exactly like I said at the beginning of the second half of the season, I think that Kai Havertz will pick it up, will play what he should play, and show what he's capable of. This is what Leverkusen are doing. They are fighting for those Champions League positions. And this is my banker over 3 goals at 1.95. But also I have a 1 unit play from this match. I cannot pass this this value on Leverkusen to win at 2.2 plus 120.
Okay, so is that 1 unit, is that an official play as well?
Yeah, absolutely. So banker and 1 unit play. 2 units play and 1 unit play.
Okay, so we're looking for a nice little 3-1 or 3-2. Cracking game, Hoffenheim and Leverkusen. Like them both. both play on the front foot. Let's see if we can score more goals than you. Okay, we're Radek, going to come to you. Augsburg at 2.15, which is plus 115. The draw at 3.88, which is plus 288. And Alex's favourite lower league team, Bremen at 3.36, plus 236. Radek, don't tell me that Alex has persuaded you that Bremen are anything more than fodder.
Unfortunately, I really don't think Bremen is better than they are in the standings at the moment. And that's why I'm supporting the home team here. And I know Augsburg didn't deliver very much within the last games. And yeah, they had not much luck against Dortmund and now lost against Union Berlin. But at home, I think they will show a different face. And a struggling team from Bremen has a long way to go to Augsburg. And I think this is the right opponent at the right time for Augsburg to strike back. And I like the odds for an Augsburg home win with 2.15 or around. And that's why I will bet on Augsburg here.
Yeah, don't blame you. I think you, anytime you get a home side plus money, desperado to get the points, I think you cannot walk past it. Now, Alex, we're going to get a team now at home and you're never, ever or very rarely going to see them with plus money. It's RB Leipzig at 1.57, which is minus 175. The draw at 4.85, which is plus 385. And Gladbach at 5.7, which is plus 470. I like both these teams, and I think entertainment is going to be five star.
We thought also Roma versus Lazio would be an easy Alex classic, but unfortunately they missed so many opportunities. More AS Roma than Lazio. I thought that they will beat them how the first half was showing. But anyway, coming back in the Bundesliga, RB Leipzig, despite controlling the match against Eintracht Frankfurt, it was the surprise, I think, in my opinion, the surprise of the round, that 2-0 defeat for RB Leipzig, who are now just 1 point clear of Bayern Munich in the first place in the standings. On the other side, Gladbach bounced back very nice with a 3-1 victory against Mainz. Mainz, a tough team despite being there on the relegation. A tough team to play against, but Gladbach played that match perfectly. Exactly what we were expecting from them to do. Yes, it should be an entertaining game. They are two great sides. They should offer us goals. Alex Classic again, both teams to score and over 2.5. This is the only value for me. If RB Leipzig were at 1.7, I would take that. But at 1.57, I will never take that price. 1.8 minus 125 in American odds, both teams to score and the over 2.5 goals in the match.
Yeah, and also when you go for the Alex Classic and you've got two teams like Roma and Lazio and they create the amount of chances but they just miss them, then you was on the right bet. You just, that's just human error and that's just part of professional sport. Radek, I'm going to come to you. Dusseldorf 3.5, which is plus 250, and the draw is 3.8, which is plus 280. And Eintracht, a measly skinny 2.13 away from home, which is plus 113, Radek.
Yeah, Dusseldorf released their coach, Friedhelm Funkel, who was leading them to a very midfield position last year. Nobody expected, and now, they had to react because they didn't win a lot of games in a row. But I think Funkel was the only person maybe who can handle this team. And if he isn't successful there, I don't think there will be a good alternative to him, and leads Düsseldorf to more success. So I think Düsseldorf will go down after this season, and I don't think there will be any effect of this change on the bench. And that's why I like the odds on Frankfurt, who have a very broad shoulders, or as we say in German, broad breast. I don't know if there's the same saying in English, but that's why I like the odds on Frankfurt here, and they are by far the better team than Düsseldorf. So yeah, I will try to.
Wow. Alex, I'm going to come to you. I thought that Frankfurt were too skinny at plus 113, but Radek seems to like it.
Yeah, I like it too. My only worry is that change of the coach, you know, and you know very good because you are playing football and you know how it is. And we discussed a lot about how that affects a group of players. But still, when Eintracht wins two matches against tough sides, Hoffenheim and leaders RB Leipzig, I mean, Düsseldorf, exactly like Radek said, I take them to go down. There is no single... they need a miracle, I don't know. The transfer window closes on Friday. They didn't bring nothing new. They didn't invest at all, only a new coach, who will not do miracles overnight with a poor side, you know. Someone on chat mentioned that Eintracht are bad on the road, but against Düsseldorf, who are showing nothing, and I watched both matches against Werder Bremen and against Bayer Leverkusen. Bayer Leverkusen could have scored 5-6 goals against Düsseldorf. They really dominated the entire match. So yeah, I'm going with the value, the plus money plus 1.113 in decimals 2.13. So yeah, Eintracht Frankfurt. I thought that they are not so good, but I've seen both matches against tough teams, and they impressed me. So I have to go with them and stay on that Eintracht train.
Okay, Radek, can you give me your banker, please?
I think I stick to Alex because he has 10 units profit. And if his bet is the same like mine, I will take the same banker, over three goals between Hoffenheim and Leverkusen.
Okay, let's hope you're not following a lemon off of a cliff, because you know that he's been on such a great road. You've not been, they say, always a bridesmaid, never the bride. Okay, Radek, have a great weekend. Have a great weekend, Alex.